Hello students, good morning everyone. I hope you are enjoying English subject. Now, in today's lecture, we are going to learn about writing composition. Writing composition means what? Writing skill, which is in English, like essay writing, letter writing, paragraph writing, advertisement writing. These are the some writing skill. From that writing skill, today we will learn about the letter writing. Now you will think that writing skill, why? Because in your English subject there are three types of part. Like first is the question depending on the stanza or the poem which is in your teaching syllabus like textbook. Second part is of grammatical part, and third part will be a writing composition part. In that writing composition, you may have to write letter writing, paragraph writing, advertisement writing, or any question depending on the beside of your syllabus. Okay, now letter writing. So now you all know letter writing. Okay, but nowadays we all are using mobile phone, so letter writing, rarely we use letter writing, but we have to know deeply about the letter writing. So now let we start letter writing. Now first tell me, there are how many types of letter writing? There are mainly two types of letters. There are mainly two types of letters. First is formal letter and second is informal letter. So formal letter means what? The official use of letter. It means that official letter we write to our senior person for requesting or applying. It means that the official letter or formal letter we use in our school, otherwise in any office for requesting something, otherwise in our school for requesting to our principal, for teacher, or for librarian, etc. So this formal type of letter usually we use to write to our senior person for requesting something or for applying something. If you are applying for any job, or if you are going to take a new admission in any other school, then that time also you can write a formal letter for requesting, for applying. Otherwise, if you are in school and if any problem is there, you are facing to any some problem, and you have to tell that problem to your teacher or to your principal, that time you can write the formal letter to your respected teachers or to your respected principal sir or ma'am. Then next type of letter is informal letter. So informal letter means what? This type of letter usually we use to our relative. Okay, this informal type of letter we use to write a letter to our relatives or friends or family members or our loving person. It means that if you want to write a letter to your friend, family member, mother, father, then after that your any other relative like grandparents, so that type of letter we use informal letter. That informal letter we usually use to our loving person or the relative ones. Now in letter writing there are five parts. Okay, in one letter there are five parts, or we can say five steps also. So first step is to form a letter. Whenever we have to form a letter or whenever we have to write a letter, these five things or these five steps we have to keep in mind. First is heading. Second is salutation or greeting. Third is the communication or the body of letter, the subscription, and last the signature or the name of writer. Now while writing formal letter or informal letter, these five things or five steps has changed little bit. It means that while writing formal letter or informal letter, the heading should be different, the salutation or greeting also will be different, the communication or body of letter, it also will be different in both type of letter. Then the subscription also different. And last, the signature or the name of writer, but it will be same. Now first see heading. In heading part, the heading consists of a writer's address and the date. In the part of heading, if you are writing the formal letter, if you are writing official use letter, in the heading part, first we will say about official letter, okay? So while writing the official letter or the formal letter, in the heading part, you have to write an address of to whom you are writing a letter. To whom you are writing the letter, that person's address in the heading part. And address should be included with date. It means that the date should be included in the address also. Then next is salutation or greeting. While you are writing formal letter, you have to write respected sir or respected ma'am or respected principal sir, principal ma'am, like that. It means that in the salutation or greeting, in your writing a formal letter, that time you have to write there respected and to whom you are writing, that sir or ma'am, etc. Next is the communication or the body of letter. While you are writing the formal letter, the communication will be in short. Okay, while you are writing the formal letter, the communication will be short and depending on the subject. Short but point giving. It means that the discussion should be not pointless. While you are writing the formal letter, the discussion should not be pointless. How much you have to write, that much only write, but your point has to be touched to that any person to whom you are writing the letter, that person. Then next is the subscription. In that the subscription, you can write yours sincerely while you are writing the formal letter, yours sincerely. And last, the signature or the name of writer. And last, after writing the subscription means yours sincerely, write your name. What is your name? XYZ. That right name. And last, do the signature of yours. That is in formal letter. Okay. Now, next is informal letter. So, in informal letter, at the heading part, in heading part, the address should be writer's. Okay, it means that if I am writing a letter in a heading part, I will write my address in informal letter. Then afterwards, salutation or greeting. In that part, I will write, if I am writing a letter to my mother, then I will write there, dear mother or dear father, dear grandmother, dear grandfather, dear friend, like that. If I am writing a letter to my loving person, then that time write a dear, and whatever or whoever you are writing a letter, that mother, father, grandparents, friend, write that name in salutation or greeting. Next is the communication or the body of letter. Now, what we saw in the formal letter, in formal letter you have to write point wise, means what is the subject related to that subject you have to write in short. Okay, but informal letter you can write how much you want. It means that there is no limitation in informal letter, because you are writing the letter to your loving person, so you can write all the things which you want, like body of letter, main body of the letter. Next is the subscription. Here you can write yours lovingly. In informal letter you can write yours lovingly friend, yours lovingly daughter, yours lovingly son, etc. And last, the signature or the name of writer. And at the last, you can write your name and you can do your signature. Now students, we can see there are two main parts of letter, formal letter and informal letter. So today we have seen formal letter and informal letter and what are the steps of forming the letter. Now in next lecture we will see deeply about the formal letter and informal letter, how to write a proper letter. थैंक यू।